My photographic career started in the digital age, and until this year I've never owned an analog camera. I was thinking about trying out film for a while, but never pulled the trigger. And then I stumbled across the Hasselblad X-Pan, and things changed quite a bit. The super wide aspect ratio gives the image an extremely cinematic look, and I was immediately hooked. The X-Pan seemed very unique, and since there is no digital camera out there that offers the same field of view, I decided to get one and to finally give film photography a try. First, it was shocking to see how expensive this camera had become, since prices have increased over the last years. But I got lucky and came across a good deal. Now, after gathering a fair bit of shooting experience with the X-Pan, I want to give you 5 reasons why you should consider to get one too. Reason number 1. Design and build quality. It is a rangefinder camera, and if you like this category of cameras, you will probably fall in love with the X-Pan like I did. It is simply a beauty, and when you take the camera in your hands, you can tell right away that this is a serious piece of kit. Besides the rubberized back door, the camera body is completely made out of metal. It weighs roughly 1 kg, including the 45mm lens. Yes, it's not a lightweight camera, but the substantial weight makes it feel extremely sturdy. Reason number 2. Ease of use. If you're used to modern cameras, and operating a film camera seems intimidating or complicated to you, then don't worry, the X-Pan is a breeze to use. Loading the camera is very straightforward and doesn't require much experience. Just put the roll in and align the film tip, that's basically it. Honestly, it doesn't take much longer than putting a SD card into a digital camera. After closing the back door, the camera will automatically check how many exposures your film will give you, and the exact number is shown on the display on top of the camera. One roll will give you usually 20 photos in total. The cool thing is that if you want to shoot in the normal 3:2 aspect ratio, you can do that at any time by setting the switch on the back of the camera accordingly. Then you will obviously get 36 images out of one roll. After loading the camera, just set the ISO dial to the corresponding speed of your roll, and then you're good to go. The X-Pan has a built-in light meter, and the shutter speed dial on top even has an automatic setting, which basically allows you to shoot in aperture priority, which is very convenient and I'm using it all the time. The camera also features an exposure compensation dial, which is more than useful if you like to overexpose your film to get a specific look like I usually do. Manual focus works just like on any other rangefinder camera, and you can get used to it very quickly. After taking a shot, there is no need to advance the film because the camera is taking care of it for you. The same applies for the film rewind after finishing a roll. You see, the simplicity makes it a breeze to use, and you can just focus on finding the perfect subject and framing your shot. Reason number 3. The aspect ratio. The X-Pan is achieving its very wide field of view by exposing 2 frames at the same time on a regular 35mm film. That gives it this super wide aspect ratio, which is even wider than on my 21:9 monitor. This format we usually associate with movies shown on a big cinema screen. The results can be really immersive, and that makes the X-Pan so unique. You may argue that you could just crop an image to get a similar result, but that is not working because the perspective wouldn't be the same. You could shoot a panorama and combine 2 or 3 shots, but when things are moving, that becomes very challenging. Reason number 4. The challenge. The X-Pan is different compared to other cameras, and so is the process of finding a suitable subject and composing an image. Because the frame is almost double in width, it can be a challenge in the beginning, and it might take some time to adjust to the new format. However, at the same time, it is presenting you with new opportunities to produce images that stand out. For me personally, the biggest challenge was and still is to deal with straight lines. Especially if the horizon is in the frame, it is even more crucial to keep it straight when shooting the X-Pan. Another challenge I haven't fully embraced yet is to shoot vertically. Something I'm not used to even when using a camera with a more normal aspect ratio. But that is something I want to check out more in the future. Reason number 5. Optical quality. So far, I have only used the 45mm f4 lens and most of the time I'm shooting it wide open. And let me tell you that this lens is superb with great sharpness even when shot wide open at f4. The background blur is also very pleasing and lets nothing to desire. In terms of overall image quality, the X-Pan produces much larger negatives compared to a regular 35mm camera, and that is resulting in less visible grain and a better overall sharpness, especially if you are using a flatbed scanner like I do. Now, let me know in the comments below if the X-Pan would be a camera you would be interested in, and for what kind of photography would you use it for. And as always, give the video a thumbs up if you liked it and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Until next time, auf Wiedersehen!